After this, I saw a large crowd with more people than could be counted. They were from every race, tribe, nation, and language, and they stood before the throne and before the Lamb. They wore white robes and held palm branches in their hands as they shouted, "Our God, who sits upon the throne, has the power to save his people, and so does the Lamb." The angels who stood around the throne knelt in front of it with their faces to the ground. The elders and the four living creatures knelt there with them. Then they all worshiped God and said, "Amen. Praise, glory, wisdom, thanks, honor, power, and strength belong to our God forever and ever. Amen." One of the elders asked me, "Do you know who these people are that are dressed in white robes? Do you know where they came from?" "Sir," I answered, "you must know." Then he told me, "These are the ones who have gone through the great suffering. They have washed their robes in the blood of the Lamb and have made them white. And so they stood before the throne of God and worshiped him in his temple day and night. The one who sits on the throne will spread his tent over them. They will never hunger or thirst again, and they won't be troubled by the sun or any scorching heat. The Lamb in the center of the throne will be their shepherd. He will lead them to streams of life-giving water, and God will wipe all tears from their eyes." Those words come from Revelation chapter 7, verses 9 to 17. How many people will stand before the throne of God and worship him? Well, these verses clearly say that number will be more than could be counted. There is a verse in Matthew 7 that says the way to God is narrow, and there will be few who find it. But according to these verses in Revelation 7, even those few will be more than could be counted. Satan wants us to feel like we are vastly outnumbered by the minions of the enemy of God. He wants you to believe that followers of Jesus are powerless to stand against evil in this world. That is simply not true. One Christian, filled with the Holy Spirit, far outnumbers all the hordes of hell. As a follower of Jesus Christ, you have a future that is assured by God Himself to be eternal and glorious in every way. Keep your eyes on the King and take every step in a direction that brings you closer to Him. Shut your ears to the alluring sound of the world which calls you back into its depressing grip. Let the music of praising Jesus echo in every word you speak. Lord Jesus, may this day bring me one day closer to the time when I will stand before you and see your face as I praise and worship you forever. Amen.